Hi, we are going to see how to create splines in Curvy Splines 8.9. First, click on the Draw Spline button. You'll see a help text box that says hold Ctrl to add control points. Hold Ctrl and you'll have multiple options. The first option is to left-click on empty space to add a control point. Each click adds a control point, forming the spline. The spline and its control points are game objects, as you can see in the hierarchy view. This is very convenient because it means all your knowledge and tools regarding game objects still apply to Curvy Splines, unlike other solutions where you need more learning before being able to interact with splines. The Curvy Spline is a game object with a Curvy Spline component, and control points are game objects with Curvy Spline segment components, which define the spline segment between the selected control point and the next one. If you don't select a spline when adding control points, a new spline is created. But if you select an existing spline and add control points, it adds to the existing spline. Control points can be added at places other than the end of a spline. To do so, select an existing control point, then add new ones to be placed after it. If you select an existing non-spline game object and add control points, it creates a spline under that game object. Now let's see the other options. Hold Ctrl again. The second option is left-clicking on the first control point to open or close the spline. You can also do this via the inspector, but we'll see this in a later video. Now, let's see the third option, which is right-clicking on empty space. This adds a new spline and connect both splines. For example, select this control point, control right-click, and you have a new spline, Curvy Spline 2, connected to the first spline. Moving this control point, which contains the connection, modifies both splines. There's another video dedicated to connections, so watch that to learn more. The fourth option is right-clicking anywhere on an existing spline. This connects both splines at the position you clicked on. With these tools, it is easy to create and connect splines quickly. Now let's see the last option, Shift to Raycast. When not using Shift, control points are created on a plane. Here, I have selected the XZ plane, so all my control points are in the XZ plane. If I switch to the YX plane and click, the control points are projected on this plane. The fourth plane option is Use View Plane. This uses the Scene View camera's plane. This is the plane perpendicular on the scene view direction. When maintaining Shift, no plane is used to project the created control points. Instead, they are projected onto the scene geometry, specifically their colliders. I'm using a planar collider here, but you can project onto any collider, including terrain. Hold Ctrl Shift and click. The control points are added to the surface. I have already made a video about full spline projection. Watch it to learn more about the subject. Here are some additional points I forgot to mention. The Draw Spline button can be activated via a hotkey. By default, it is the Space button, but you can change this in the Preferences menu. Splines can also be created the classic way, by using the Unity menus. I hope this video was helpful. The next one will be about the different spline types, such as Bezier splines and B splines. Please subscribe so you don't miss it, and have a nice day.